Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. A new NASA report describes the potential dangers that the electrical environments of asteroids could pose to astronauts in future space missions. NASA scientists are now attempting to create computer models that will successfully predict dangerous electrical interactions between an approaching spacecraft and an asteroid. The report begins with a brief, surprising description of space rarely seen in official NASA press releases. Space may appear empty, a soundless vacuum, but it's not an absolute void. It flows with electric activity that is not visible to our eyes. The Electric Universe theory, as developed by Wal Thornhill, has always stated that comets and asteroids are charged bodies that sometimes discharge as they interact with the sun's weak electric field. However, while NASA's new investigation may seem like a concession of these points, a closer examination reveals that little has changed in their theoretical approach.
You could be forgiven for thinking, after reading a report from NASA on June the 25th, titled "New NASA Model Gives Glimpse into the Invisible World of Electric Asteroids," that somehow or another, NASA was beginning to take heed of the electric universe. But when you read the article, you realize nothing could be further from the truth. The article begins with some promise. It says, and I quote, "Space may appear empty, a soundless vacuum, but it's not an absolute void. It flows with electric activity that is not visible to our eyes. NASA is developing plans to send humans to an asteroid and wants to know more about the electrical environment explorers will encounter there." It seems that this concern really sprang from unexpected electrostatic effects when the astronauts first visited the moon. It was found that the dust from the surface clung to everything, and there were obvious electrical effects in the dust's behavior. This particular article goes on and talks about the solar wind, which is blown from the surface of the sun at about 1,000,000 miles per hour and flows around all solar system objects, forming swirling eddies and vortices in its wake. Magnetic fields carried by the solar wind warp, twist and snap as they slam into the magnetic fields around other objects in our solar system, blasting particles to millions of miles per hour and sending electric currents surging in magnetic storms that, around the Earth, can damage sensitive technology like satellites and power grids. So this electricity is really dangerous stuff. But here we see the usual false ideas. A solar wind blown from the surface of the sun? It is not blown from the surface of the sun. It accelerates away from the sun. And what's more, the highest speed winds come from the coolest parts of the sun, known as coronal holes. So it's not the heat of the sun that accelerates these particles throughout the solar system. It is an electric field. And then this article goes on to talk about magnetic fields, which do all the work. They twist and snap. Well, there is no way you can snap a magnetic field. A magnetic field line is a concept like a line of longitude or latitude, which cannot snap. It is merely a concept. So if the magnetic fields are not causing these energetic events, what is? Well, the electric universe turns it all around and says the very things that you're observing, these electric currents surging in magnetic storms, are the main drivers. They are the things that actually create the magnetic fields in the solar wind. So when you treat the sun and the other objects in the solar system as charged bodies, and that the solar wind is actually a plasma which can transfer current from one object to another, you begin to see things in an entirely different light.
Occasional cometary displays by asteroids is a long-standing puzzle for mainstream science. The puzzle became more complicated in late 2013 when astronomers observed an asteroid with an astonishing 6 comet-like tails. The asteroid has since been officially recategorized as a main belt comet. While NASA is now investigating the electrical environments of asteroids, the limited surface effects that mainstream theory describes will never explain the observed phenomena.
The article says, "On airless objects like moons and asteroids, sunlight ejects negatively charged electrons from matter, giving sunlit areas a strong positive electric charge." Now, this is taking a very simplistic view, rather like we see with comets. What happens on the surface of the moon or on an asteroid or on comets is all due to solar radiation and surface effects. photoelectric effects, that kind of thing. The electric universe says that an asteroid is a charged object, rather like a comet, and that the charge on its surface will be greater than anything imagined by scientists at NASA. It's merely common sense when sending astronauts to an asteroid that you should make sure that they are earthed to the spacecraft or to the asteroid. It's the same kind of problem that electronics engineers face when messing around with transistorized circuits. They must also be earthed so that they don't discharge to the electronic circuits and blow the transistors. The last thing the astronauts want is for their electronics to fail on touchdown on an asteroid.
In 2005, Wall Thornhill and the Thunderbolts Project published a series of successful predictions before NASA's Deep Impact mission to Comet Temple 1. Among these, Thornhill suggested that the copper projectile fired at the comet would produce not one, but two bright flashes, including an advanced electrical flash before impact to the comet's surface.
The electric universe makes a more significant warning. Based on the electrical model of comets and asteroids, I made the prediction before the Deep Impact mission that when the probe approached the comet, there would be a spark before it touched the comet. And this is what was seen. It's been explained away in various ways which are hardly sensible or feasible. But having predicted it, it was something that should have been investigated as a possibility. But it hasn't been. And this is one of the things which will dog the astronauts who try and land on an asteroid, that the charge on the asteroid may be greater than expected. But there is one saving grace with plasma, and that is that if the approach is slow enough, the plasma itself will act as a conductor between the spacecraft and the asteroid and will equalize the charge, so that all that is required, in my opinion, as the astronauts in their spacecraft approach the asteroid, is that some kind of lightning conductor is aimed at the asteroid from the spacecraft before the closest approach.
The electric universe theory proposes that neither comets nor asteroids are primordial leftovers from the formation of the solar system, but rather, they are the products of recent planetary catastrophes. An opportunity to test this theory arrived in 2004 with NASA's Stardust mission to the comet Vilt 2. A chemical analysis of a sample from the comet's dust tail astonished scientists around the world, revealing a mineral composition vastly different from the expected aggregation of ices and primordial interstellar dust. Despite these findings, scientists continue to assume that both comets and asteroids are Rosetta stones, providing insight into the early solar system.
Like many of the space probes by NASA, the reason given for the actual experiments are that we're visiting asteroids because they are relatively pristine remnants from the formation of the solar system, quoting from the article. So they give clues as to how the planets formed and life originated. Now, this is one of the areas where NASA is completely wrong, because the story of the solar system and how it was formed has never been shown to work. It is merely a story. The electric universe, on the other hand, has looked at the recent history of the solar system as recorded by our ancient forebears in various ways, and it seems that the solar system has had a recent chaotic spasm during which material has been ripped from the surface of Mars in particular, but also other bodies, and hurled into space. And asteroids and comets, in that scenario, are the remnants of planetary surfaces. Now, it's always been acknowledged that asteroids show some kind of processing, the minerals and so on from the asteroids show that they have been on a planetary surface. But this is assumed to have been the result of collisions early on in the formation of the solar system. We're saying these things are quite recent and that there is no real difference between comets and asteroids. And this particular claim has been borne out by almost every experiment done to determine the composition of comets. So it's important that we do try and find out more about asteroids, because this will tell us about the recent history of the solar system and may actually give us the clues we need to be absolutely certain that the story of the chaotic history of the solar system and the destruction of the Martian surface is correct. It should be made clear that the magnetic field contained by the solar wind is not explained. The magnetic fields on the sun are not well explained either. The so-called convection zone beneath the surface of the sun that is supposed to generate the magnetic fields has not been found. So NASA keeps falling into this trap of using magnetism, mysteriously generated or magically generated, to explain everything that goes on in the solar system. And that even applies to the electric currents, which they acknowledge, between Jupiter and Saturn and their respective moons. Until we can see that the electric currents are primary causes and not merely effects, NASA will find more anomalies.
For continuous updates on space news from the Electric Universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.